is the one singled out in creating in the mulk, in ownership, and tadbir, arranging the affairs. He did not mention it, but you could say yudabbiru al-amr. I don't know which verse it is, but I know the verse. I will get it for you inshallah ta'ala next week. يدبر الأمر يدبر الأمر. Yeah, I don't remember where it is. الحمد لله على كل حال. فإن قلت shall we deal with this or not? We'll deal with this inshallah. Why not? فإن قلت كيف نجمع بين ما قررت وبين إثبات الخلق لغير الله مثل قوله تعالى فتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين ومثل قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم في المصورين يقال لهم أحيوا ما خلقتم ومثل قوله تعالى في الحديث القدسي ومن أظلم ممن ذهب يخلق خلقي فكيف تجمع بين قولك أن الله منفرد بالخلق وبين هذه النصوص. Now the Shaykh, may Allah mercy on him, had a very nice style in his tafsir, that he would strike what could potentially be said by someone. Although he will say, what if someone said this? He will tell you how to answer already. Yani he's preparing you for anything. First he explains to you, then he realizes that there might be some misconceptions with some people who may ask you something. So he automatically tells you, if somebody tells you this, then this is how you explain it. To give you fully equipped, yani, mashallah. So he says, so if you say, or if someone says, how do we bring a relation between the fact that we say that Allah is the only creator, and between the fact that Allah mentioned in verses in the Quran and hadith that there are other creators alongside with him? We will see what is meant by that. Allah says, فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. So blessed is Allah, the best of creators. Now look, now this might be a misconception for someone. Allah said, so blessed be Allah, تبارك الله, the best of creators. They must be, according to this one, glory be to Allah, the best of creators. According to the verse, there's more than one. We will see how this is understood. And like the statement of the Prophet ﷺ regarding the image, the people who take pictures. Now of course, when we talk about pictures, there's a difference of opinion whether the photography and the camera is included. I'm not going to deal with fiqh right now. But the least we could say, images that are drawn with the hand or carved as a statue, these are certainly under the violation of prohibition. And the Prophet ﷺ said, it will be said to them on the Day of Judgment, أَحْيُوا مَا خَلَقْتُمْ, give life to that which you created. So somebody who builds a statue, he is trying to imitate the quality of Allah. Who are you to create or to make the shape of a creation? This is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does. That's why it's prohibited in Islam. This is how shirk began. But statues, they built statues of righteous people, next thing you know, they're worshipping them. Otherwise there was no shirk in the beginning. So yes, Nuh was sent to them. It started at the end of the time of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Adam was the first prophet. He wasn't a messenger. And everybody was worshipping Allah. Fine. What happened is a group of righteous men died. The shaitan, may Allah curse him, came to the people who were left behind. Said, look man, these people were very righteous. And it is a waste to let them go. And nothing is established for their remembrance. Why don't you build a statue with their appearance in order for you to use them as means of encouragement? Whenever you feel low and you're not worshipping Allah properly, notice, to worship Allah properly, you look at these statues, you remember these men, so it will encourage you to worship Allah better. So they took the advice of the shaitan and they established these statues. Time passed and generations came, and they did not understand the objective of this statue. So people started dedicating some of their worship to these statues as intercessors with Allah. Not to worship them alone, to worship them alongside with Allah. And if you read Surah Nuh, وَقَالُوا لَا تَذَرُنَّ آلِهَتَكُمْ, do not abandon your gods. وَلَا تَذَرُنَّ وُدًّا وَلَا سُوَاعًا وَلَا يَغُوثَ وَيَعُوقَ وَنَسْرًا. These are the names of these five brothers who died. The disbelievers, when Nuh was sent to them and said, leave alone these statues, worship Allah alone, they said, لا تذرن آلهتكم, do not leave your gods alone. Do not leave Wuddan, Wudd his name, سواعن يغوث يعوق ونصر, these five gods. Subhanallah. Shirk began like this. The shaitan, and this is the tricks of the shaitan. He doesn't tell you sometimes automatically, come do the evil. He will slowly but surely pull you in, gradually, until he puts you down in the hole. That's why we have to be careful of the tricks of the shaitan. That's why Allah told us in the Quran, إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ. He is to you a clear enemy. So the shaitan will not tell you, you're a Muslim, you know zina, adultery, fornication is something that is way out of your mind. أعوذ بالله. You wouldn't do it. So the shaitan will not tell you, Allah, go rape a woman in the street, because this is something a Muslim would never do. يعني he, unless يعني أستغفر الله. But يعني your iman prevents you. But he will tell you, why don't you speak to this woman and give her da'wah? And you start giving her da'wah, and then you start loving one another, then you start sending love letters. The next thing you know, you fall into the same thing that you were not supposed to fall in, but he dragged you in from the little door until he brought you to where he wants. So if we knew the tricks of the shaitan, we'd be able to protect ourselves. And that's why we were, a part of the deen of Islam is to say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, I seek refuge in Allah. Because if Allah controls the shaitan, it's not like the shaitan is independent. He has his own establishment, his own property that is independent from Allah. He is under the command of Allah. Allah allowed him to do what he does. When you seek refuge in Allah, you ask Allah to protect you from his creation, the shaitan. So this is important that we know that. So anyways, the hadith, another hadith Qudsi says, Allah says, and who is more oppressing? Who is more oppressive than the one who goes and he tries to create like my creation? So Allah again attributed the term of creating. So how do we bring in a relationship with these texts? One time we say Allah is the only creator. Next thing you know, we have verses in a hadith that indicate that there are other creators. The Shaykh says, فَالْجَوَابُ أَنْ يُقَالْ إِنَّ الْخَلْقَ هُوَ الْإِيجَادِ وهذا خاص بالله تعالى أما تحويل الشيء من صورة إلى أخرى فإنه ليس بخلق حقيقة وإن سمي خلقا باعتبار التكوين لكنه في الواقع ليس بخلق تام فمثلا هذا النجار صنع من الخشب بابا فيقال خلق بابا لكن مادة هذه الصناعة الذي خلقها هو الله عز وجل لا يستطيع الناس كلهم مهما بلغوا في القدرة أن يخلقوا عود أراك أبدا ولا أن يخلقوا ذرة ولا أن يخلقوا ذبابا. He said, the answer is, creation is to bring something into existence. Creation is to bring something into existence, and this is specific and only for Allah Azza wa Jal alone. As for transforming something from one matter to another, this is also called linguistically khalq, but it is not in essence. The original creation is from Allah. And the Shaykh mentioned example. He said this is not really creating, although it could be mentioned, it could be, the same term could be used to it because of you putting this thing together, although it didn't exist before. But it is not in its ultimate sense. For example, if what do you call the person who carpenter? He builds a door. You could say he created this door. You see, I created an email account. Created an email account. Okay, create really. But that term is used. The term is used. You create a door, you created a concept, you create something. But the essence, but who made the wood? Allah Azza wa Jal. All you did was get something Allah created and you did something to it, and now it has another reality, another element. But at the end of the day, it may be called creation linguistically, but is it really creating? No. Because if make wood, make the wood, if anyone can do this, then there will be an issue. But no one can do this. You understand it? How you, this is understood. So the Shaykh said, anytime people are using something, they're using material that Allah has already created. All they're doing is transforming it from one phase to another phase. It is linguistically said, khalq, creating, but not in its ultimate sense, which is bringing something into existence from nothing. Tayyib, from scratch, as they say. This only belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even that they do right now from cloning the animals. Tell them, don't clone an animal. Create an animal. Make one and blow a soul into it. Let it move in front of me. They will never be able to do that. But they try to use tricks. And this is all... And Allah says in the Quran, he said that, anyways, the Shaykh said the people will not even be able to create, you know, the siwak? Not even a miswak. Not even a stick. Not even a grain. Not even an ant. And not even a fly. And the evidence for that, Allah Azza wa Jal says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ ضُرِبَ مَثَلٌ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ. O mankind, an example has been struck. So listen to it. This is Allah speaking to His creation. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ لَنْ يَخْلُقُوا ذُبَابًا وَلَوْ اجْتَمَعُوا لَهُ. Those who you are calling on to besides Allah will not create a fly, even if they were all to come together. Even they were all to come together in assistance, one another to create it. وَإِن يَسْلُبُهُمُ الذُّبَابُ شَيْئًا لَا يَسْتَنْقِذُوهُ مِنْ. Even if the fly was to take something from them, they cannot even retrieve it. If you're eating some food, and the fly came and had a lick of your fool in Tamiz, some of the fool, and went, for the sake of Allah, can you get it back? Khalas, it took it, digested it, it changed, now it's part of its blood. You're going to squish the fly, tayyib. Get the Tamiz back, get the fool back, no more. This is how helpless we are. And this is us human beings who we have, we can function. Then what about a statue that you had to create, you had to carve? You need to wash him, shower him, wipe him, keep him fresh. Yani, if you have the ability to do something, you can do a fly. So what about these statues of the people who are worshiping besides Allah? Yani, it's even more difficult for them to do anything like that. ضعف الطالب والمطلوب. Allahu Akbar. Oh, subhanAllah. Let me see here. 7:09. Okay, we will be, we have a couple of minutes for Isha, for the Adhan. So we will stop, inshallah.